Good morning, dear student. Student, we are reading about the computer language. Okay? So, in the last class, you read about the types of computer language. That's low level language and high level language. Yes? So, yesterday you read two types of low level language, machine level language and assembly language. So machine language read the binary digit, okay, and assembly language read the mnemonic code, okay. So yeah, so assembly language, that's called symbolic programming language. Yep. Okay student, clear? Two type of language, machine language and assembly language. So today we will discuss about the high level language. Okay. So you know that this is a four type of high level language. Okay, so high level language distributed in four type. So first, algebraic formulating, you know, first algebraic formulating and second, your business data processing language, and your third is object oriented programming language. Object oriented programming language. Okay. And your last high level language is visual programming language. Visual programming language. Okay, student. So that is four type high level language. So what is high level language, student? So high level language are the symbolic language. High level language are the symbolic language in which English word or mathematics symbol are used instead of mnemonic code. Okay student, yes, you know mnemonic code. You know familiar about the mnemonic code? Yes. So these symbols indicated to short sequence of letter like A for addition, C for comparison, L for loading and M for multiplication. Okay. Yeah. So this is a mnemonic code, and mnemonic code used in assembly language. Yes, student? Yes. But we will talk about the high level language. So high level language are symbolic language. Okay, so this one is a symbolic language. Okay student, yes. So high level language is a symbolic language in which English word or mathematical symbols, okay, are used instead of mnemonic codes, okay, and such languages are considered, okay, so such type that languages considered to be high level language because they are closer to human language. Okay, student, clear that such that type language are considered to be high level language. They are close to human language. Okay, so again, as we all know that computer only understood machine language. You know that machine language, that means 0 and 1 binary code. Okay, student?
Yes.
So we all know that computer understand machine language. So the program written in the high level language are translated into the machine language, okay, by using this translator called interpreter and compiler. Okay, student, mostly people use in assembly language after the machine language, but machine language coding and decoding translate into machine language. Yes, so machine language, assembly language into machine language translated by assembler. Yes, so same thing with this high level language. Okay, student? Yes, so any type high level language we can do programming, so that program convert into which program? High level language program convert into machine language. Why? Because computer understand only machine language, okay, and you know machine language is 0 and 1, okay, 0 and 1 is binary digit. So that program written in the high level language are translated into machine language by using translator called interpreter and compiler. Okay, yes, so that's high level language convert into machine language by interpreter and compiler. Compiler and interpreter. Okay, student? Yes. So this method, by converting the high level language into machine language. Clear, student? Yes. And we will talking about the first high level language. So first high level language is algebraic formulating language. So my topic is going on high level language. So here my answer, high level language and first algebraic formulating formula type processing language. Algebraic formula type language. Okay, student. Algebraic formula type processing language. Language. So that's your algebraic formula type processing language. Okay?
Yes.
So that's your first. So there are many high level languages developed for performing different variety of tasks. Okay? And some of them are specialized and others are quite general purpose. So HLL, you know that means low level LLL and high level language in short form HLL. Okay, are categorized, you know, four type. So you know what the first high level language? First high level language was designed. Okay. In 1950. Okay, student, clear? Yes, this is a very important question. So high level languages were designed in 1950. Okay?
Yes.
So that's algebraic formula type processing language. So these languages are especially used for solving math, medical and statistical problem. Okay? Yes. So this language used for especially for solving mathematical and statistical problems. Okay? Yes. For example, what is the algebraic formula type processing language? So this is first basic. Okay? Yes. So what's the full form of basic? Basic beginners all purpose symbolic instruction code. Okay, student? So that's beginners all purpose that as for symbolic instruction and code. Okay. Instruction code. Okay. So this is the first example of basic beginners all purpose symbolic instruction code. And this program used for solving mathematical and statistical problems. Okay, student? Yes. And second, Fortran. Okay? So that's Fortran, that's formula translator, FOR formula, and TRAN translation. translation and the other example of algebraic formula type processing language, that's Algol, that algorithmic language. Okay, so this is algorithmic algorithmic language, L for language. Okay, yes. So and then last example, APL, a programming language. A for A, P for programming, and L for language. Okay students, yes. So here are four example for the algebraic formula type processing language. Okay, basic, Fortran, Algol and APL. Clear? And your next so please learn the full form of that. Okay students, and your second high level language, business data processing language. Business data processing language. Okay, so that business data processing language, so this language show their capabilities for maintaining data processing procedures and file handling problem. Okay, so this language show their capabilities for maintaining data processing procedures and file handling problem. Okay, for example, for that COBOL and RPG. So what is the full form of COBOL? Common business oriented language. C for common, B for business oriented language. Okay, yeah. So and RPG, report program generator. Report program generator. Okay student, yeah. So here are two example for the business data processing language. So COBOL and RPG. So COBOL, common business oriented language, and that RPG, report program generator. And your third example of the high level language, object oriented programming language. Object oriented programming language. So in this programming language, all the files, input and output are considered as discrete object, and the program dealing with these are part of the same object. Okay, and that example C++, Java, okay, yes, etc. There are many example of object oriented programming language. Okay, so in this programming language, all the files, input and outputs are considered as discrete object, and the program dealing with these are part of the same object. Okay, and the example of the object oriented program C++ and Java. Okay, so and your last high level language, visual programming. Okay, so that's your last visual programming language. So these are the programming language especially designed for building Windows based information application. Okay, so that's example Visual Basic, Visual Java and Visual C++. That's example Visual Basic, Visual Java and Visual C++, etc. Okay, yes, so that's clear about the high level language. Okay, so this are programming languages especially designed for building Windows based application. Okay, yes, so that's complete your high level language, and in the next class we will discuss about the advantages of high level language and what is the language processor, you know, language processor, compiler and interpreter, and we will doing the question answer. Okay student, so please read about the high level language and learn 4 of category, and next class we will discuss about the advantages and language processor and question answer. Thank you so much. Have a good day.